This recording is protected by copyright. No part may be reproduced without the prior permission of the University of South Australia.
Hello and welcome. This is the program, the Bachelor of Management, Human Resource Management, and I'm the program director, Christina Scott-Young. So welcome. Glad to see you've got up out of bed early and come along. Now I'm going to tell you a little bit about our program, and our first question is, why would you study human resource management at UniSA? Well, my question to you is, why not? But there are a number of reasons. First of all, the academics that you'll be taught by, the people who teach you, are international researchers researching at the cutting edge of their field, so you'll be taught with the latest knowledge. It's the only specialty program in HRM in Adelaide. And because of that, we are highly in demand by employers. Now, I guess most of you are doing a degree because you want a career. Well, this is a really, University of SA is really well connected with the HR professionals in the field. We meet with them regularly. They regularly ring me up and ask for students who are graduating from our program to come and interview for their jobs. So I believe in it very much. That's a really good program. We also have extremely close relationships with AHRI, which is the Australian Human Resource Management Institute, and that's the peak body for all HR professionals. They hold lots of training seminars. Now, as a student, a full-time student, you are entitled to free membership of AHRI, and you are entitled to go to all their events for free, and that involves networking. And what we encourage our students to do right from the beginning is to network. Network with the professionals that you come across, network with each other, because the person you're sitting next to in class may actually be somebody who you might go and ask for a job for. And we know that most jobs are got through who we know rather than applying in the paper. Okay, so there's a heavy demand for our students. They are very well thought of in the community. In fact, I'm very proud to be associated with this program. Okay, so what do you need to get in? Well, the minimum is an ATAR for 2012 entry of 70.8. So I'm suspecting it'll be the same for 2013 entry. But the preferred score is 75. But as long as you're up around that 71 mark, you should be fine. If you find your ATAR score isn't good enough, if you're coming out of year 12, you can actually come in other ways. There are alternative pathways. You can come through special entry, through STAT, or you can go to TAFE and do some courses and come in via that way. So don't feel bad if something happens towards the end of the year in your exams. Okay. So what's the program about? Well, every program in the Division of Business will do 8 core courses, okay? 8. And that means you can actually swap between programs. If you come into our program and say, hey, we don't like it, which is very unusual, but you can actually move into one, you could move into a Bachelor of Marketing. Okay. Once you've done your 8 core division courses, you then do 10 majors, which are in our HRM area, and we'll talk about those later. Then you can do 5, or you do 6 electives, 5 that are meant to be in the Division of Business and 1 that is free. So you could do massage therapy or whatever, anything you like. It's a fun one. Or you could be very serious and you could do 6 professional ones. So you could actually get a minor in another subject. You could do 6, 5 or 4 and get a minor in marketing if you did marketing. So you can actually get some concentrations as well. So basically there's 8 division cores, 10 HRM subjects and 6 electives that you choose. Now, we're very flexible in our delivery. You can do all your courses online, and they're called external or online. You don't have to come into classes at all, which is a great boon for those of you who work or those of you who need to work to get through uni. We also have after-hour lectures, after 5 o'clock, and tutorials to cater for the people who are working, because a lot of our students are working. You can study part-time, you can study full-time. You can design your own course. We give you a lot of freedom. There's a lot more freedom here than any university that I've worked at. It's really good. You can also fast track your degree. We have summer schools and winter schools where you can do maybe a week study or very intensive short courses and get extra classes in that way. Or you can just study over that period, over the December, January period, or the winter, I think, is June, July. Okay. The other thing we do offer, and we certainly encourage at UniSA, and I think it's one of our pluses, is we offer overseas exchange programs. Now, I'm not going to talk about that because we've got somebody from the overseas exchange program to talk to you in a minute about that, but I would really encourage you. We live in a global workplace. The fact that you've been overseas is a real advantage. There are scholarships to help you, this funding to help you go over. So I'd really encourage that. I've worked over in the US and I know that employers are looking for, especially the bigger companies, are looking for people who've actually had some experience in another culture. Okay, so what is the human resource management industry about? So if you're going to do this degree, what kind of work can you expect to do? Well, human resource management covers a whole wide range. Some people who work in HR, we call it, will be generalists and they'll do all the different HR specialties. Some people will be specialists and just do one. So things, very important things that HR practitioners do are recruitment and retention. So getting the best talent into the company and keeping them. Working in industrial relations with Fair Work Australia, we now have some interesting cases coming up. So workers have more power than they did under the previous government. So industrial relations has come back as a fairly important part of an HR professional's role. Remuneration or payroll, that could be a specialty or part of the job. Training, developing people. And occupational health and safety, making sure that the workplace is a safe, happy, stress-free environment. But every organisation that's of a moderate size will at least have one HR professional to look after the people side of their business. Smaller ones sometimes not, but usually medium-sized ones will, and they'll often have a whole department or unit. So there's great career opportunities for you. This is one of the fastest growing occupations in Australia. Talent, management of people is the thing that we know makes a business succeed or fail. So businesses are finally catching on that we really need people who are specialised and talented in doing this work, and so the jobs are opening up. In the last 5 years, employment has risen. And it's expected to grow strongly, which is a really good thing because we're in the global financial crisis and the recession still. So it's not every job that has a future. But this particular job does, because companies are always going to have people unless they find a way to replace us by robots and computers. But they haven't quite got there yet. So in 2015 to 2016, when a lot of you will be graduating, if you're full-time, there's expected to be a growth and there will be jobs, plenty of jobs available. And hopefully most of them will be in the Adelaide area for you. Okay. So the career pathways, you can go into the industry as an HR manager, so a generalist, or a private HR consultant. So you could have your own business, consulting to a lot of companies. You could go into occupational health and safety, big business for that, in mining, in construction, manufacturing. You could be a training and development coordinator, always a need for that. You could be an in-house trainer or a consultant, again. Recruitment, there are specialist recruitment agencies. You could go into just payroll, remuneration and benefits. I know UniSA just advertised for somebody just to do payroll recently. You can do change. Change is a big thing that's happening, you probably know, in business these days. So that seems to be an area where there is a lack of people with specialty skills. So if you want to go, if you like bringing about change in organisations and helping people get on board, that might be a good area to specialise in. You can also be in a project officer or industrial relations advisor. So it's a really good degree because there are many, many options in many fields. So why would you study here? Well, like I've said before, it's a great course, but we're also professionally accredited. So the Australian Human Resource Management Institute, AHRI, has accredited us. We have that stamp of approval. So if you go anywhere in Australia, our degree is recognised by the industry. The other good thing is we're also internationally recognised. We have the stamp of approval from the Society for HRM, which is the big American society that doesn't give away these approvals lightly. So your qualification is globally recognised, because if America recognises a qualification, anyone will respect that recognition. So those are really good things. We got that last year, the international recognition. So that shows the high quality of our program. The other thing, we have regular meetings with HR managers, the senior level managers from like Coca-Cola, Santos, the big government departments. They come and advise us on our curriculum, and they look at what we're doing and they say, there's a new movement out here in industry. We think your students need to do something like this. And in fact, they suggested we put some change management in there. So the curriculum is constantly being responsive to what the needs are out in industry. The other thing is we have scholarships, which are university scholarships for Indigenous, for low income, for rural people. So check out the scholarships, you just may be eligible. We also have over 40 prizes and awards. So they're really nice to put on you, nice little bit of money and nice to put in on your CV to say you've excelled. So the other thing we offer our students is we want you to go out and be able to hit the ground running. We teach you about the theory and research on HRM, but we also teach you practical skills, and we give you an opportunity to practice those skills out in the real world. So we have project-based courses where you can go out into organisations and work on an HR problem. They may have problem motivating their staff and engaging them. You may actually go and work in that company for a few months and work out a strategy and a plan to help change things. Work placements as well as the project-based course. We have internships. We have student exchange programs. We also have a wonderful program of mentors who are from industry, and you can get matched up with the mentors via another unit, but they will actually, you'll get somebody from industry who's working who will actually help you through deciding your career path, networking, maybe even help you get a job. So that's a wonderful thing we offer as well. Okay, so we've got a student testimonial here. I might just let you read that if you can. I'm not sure whether, can those at the back see that? Okay. But basically, our student is saying she really, the last one says, I'm very happy to have completed my degree at UniSA because the courses were useful and interesting. Okay, she talks about she had an opportunity to build character. And that's what we hope, that you'll not just learn head knowledge, but you'll develop skills and self-awareness and work-based skills that will hold you in good stead when you get out into the field. The other thing I've been asked to advertise to you is that on Tuesday, the 11th of September, there's something called a Taste of Business and Law Careers. So this is an information session for you, which I'd really, if you can come along, that would be great. It just gives you an idea of the kind of careers you can do if you enrol in any of our business or law courses. So of course the HRM, there will be people from HRM there, but it just gives you a broad way of looking at things. So that's 4:30 on Tuesday the 11th of September. at the Bradley Forum, which is in the beautiful Smart Hawk building. Bradley Forum is a wonder to behold. It has beautiful screens. These screens would be all around the room. It's a very nice room. So just think about that. If you want to find out more about that, go onto our website, onto the UniSA website. And just a little last plug for me before I hand over to the other people. I'm Christina Scott-Young, the program director. You tend to come to me if you're worried about things or not doing well or want to do exchange, those sorts of things, or just need some support, need a friendly ear to listen to. Now, Lucy Kimber is the person you go to if you need a study plan or you suddenly try to enrol and the enrolment's closed. Lucy is our admin person, and she can open up those things to you. What you will find is everyone is very friendly and open and wants to help you. We're student-centric. We want you to do well, so we want you to see us as people who will facilitate your time here. And we really hope that you decide to join us. So maybe next year I will look forward to seeing some of you around campus. So thank you very much for listening. Now I'm going to hand over to the next speaker who will talk about student exchange.
Thank you very much, Christina. My name's Anna, and I am also in my last year, thank goodness it's taken a while, of Human Resource Management degree. Just to let you know that there is a lot of flexibility. I've been doing it for a long time. I did my career first and then got into the world of Human Resource Management, so I'm nearly there. Very excited, put the gown on. But what I do want to mention is that because I have had an extended career overseas, Human Resource Management in particular, we do involve ourselves in lots of areas where individuals come from diverse cultural backgrounds. So student exchange is very important to us. When you do go out and get a job, you may find that a lot of your fellow graduates will be applying for the same job. So how do you get the job? You go overseas, that's what you do, and you do something different just to stand out. So that's what I'm going to talk to you about today. What is student exchange? So you complete part of your degree overseas with one of our partners. We do have quite a few partners out there. 80 partners in 25 countries, that's not bad. And you get to go basically anywhere that you would really like to go. You don't pay tuition fees, of course, for this because it's part of your UniSA fees. And you, as I said before, 80 universities around the world, the majority of which teach in English. If, however, you do feel that you'd like to do a course in Spanish, we've got that covered too. So we've thought of everything. So why should you go? Well, as I said before, businesses operate in a largely global environment. And it's very important that we do give you the opportunity to have a global education. And you get to practice your intercultural communication skills. It's very important that we know these skills these days because, as I said before, we work in diverse cultural backgrounds and we need to be culturally aware of those. So you learn, you gain international learning experience and the understanding of key cross-cultural concepts and connect with networks of other people. And as Christina said before, it's very important to do our networking because in today's world, it's not what you know, it's also who you know. You might want to work overseas, you know, and making that connection with some overseas networking while you're over there doing an exchange, which hopefully you will, is very important. So we have a short-term exchange, which can be from 2 to 4 to 8 weeks, to long-term exchange, which ranges from one semester to a whole year, if you're that keen. And also we've got study tours, internships, and placements. And we give you money to do it, because we do realise that studying overseas does involve a certain expense. I do have a student, I always mention this student, because he was one of the most brilliant. He put his applications down for travel grants and for internship grants and all sorts of things, and he ended up with $16,500 worth of funding. And as you can appreciate, that's quite a lot of money. So much so that he had enough time. He studied at Brock University in Canada, and he had enough time to actually go down to Niagara Falls, and then he went somehow, I don't know how, don't ask me, he ended up on The Price is Right, the Drew Carey Show. I've seen the video. And he won a barbecue. So that was part of his exchange experience, and a lot of intercultural communication went on as well, I can tell you. It's all on the video, but it can become very interesting when you do this. Also, the Australian government give the overseas help loan to students, and if you claim Centrelink payments, you can have those paid into your account while you're away as well. So we try our best to do what we can to get you all out there. So I'm hoping that when you do come to study with us, that I'll see some of you saying, hey, I want to do that exchange thing that you were talking about a couple of years ago. So hopefully I will. My name's Anna Prandalos. My details are up there. I do have a booth in the library if you want to come and see me, or if you haven't already seen me. I don't know. I've seen so many people already. But if you do want to come and see me, I'm stuck in the corner in the library. Do come, and I can speak a little bit more about it. Thank you very much for listening. Thank you, Christina.
Thank you, Anna. I'm sure you'll all be applying now you've heard of $16,000. And The Price is Right. Well, even without The Price is Right. Yeah, that's. I don't think that's the norm, but certainly there's lots of funding to help you do it, so why not do it if you can? Now, the other thing I'd like to say, if you cannot, say you've got family commitments, not everybody can get away, but don't despair, because we have a wonderful global culture here on campus. You will be in classes with people from Burma, Thailand, Vietnam, Germany, the US, China, Malaysia, Singapore, you name it, you'll be with them. So the other thing I would suggest you do is network with them. You're actually building your, you can build your global network right here on campus without ever leaving little old Adelaide. So make sure you take opportunities to do that. They may be a little shy. Welcome them. Invite them to your home. Be friendly and hospitable, and those friendships sometimes last for a lifetime and may lead to wonderful job opportunities. Okay, so now we're going to move on to Gabrielle, who has actually done an exchange recently, since we last met last year. But Gabrielle's going to talk to you about what it's like, she's a student ambassador, what it's like in the to be a student here. I mean, I can tell you from my experience, but I'm not a student, but Gabrielle is. So you get it from the, not the horse's mouth, but the student's mouth.
Hi everybody. So my name is Gabriella, and I've recently graduated from a degree in management, majoring in human resource management. So Christina was my program director. Well, thank you all for coming today. So hopefully I'll give you a bit of an insight into my experiences of being a student at University of South Australia. I think firstly, we've mentioned a lot through the presentations, this one and the previous ones, about the opportunities available at UniSA, and also why it's a great university to come to, so namely definitely its size and how recognised it is within the industry, within Australia, and also globally, with a lot of recognition that university is definitely experiencing. Probably something that many of you are keen to know, being in a human resource management, I suppose, information session is why to study this degree. So as Christina spoke about, there are a lot of different areas within HR, and it's definitely not limited to one specific area. So through my time studying HR, I've learnt a lot about employment law, industrial relations, organisational behaviour, training and development, occupational health and safety management, all those areas which I can then now proceed to actually work in within the industry, either being a generalist, looking at all those different areas, and perhaps down the track maybe specialising in specific ones depending on where my path takes me. Probably a major area I'd like to talk about is AHRI, the Australian Human Resource Institute. So I'm currently on the Young Professionals Committee in South Australia of AHRI. So we do lots of networking sessions throughout the year and engage lots of young professionals and not so young professionals in both, you know, who are new to HR, so people essentially that have been industry 5 years or less, or students and recent graduates, so quite a large spectrum of people within our AHRI Young Professionals Network. And it's really an opportunity to network. So over the 3 years studying my degree, and I do recommend that many of you do the same thing, is to sort of find out those different networks and actually build on them. So by the time now, in final year, having graduated, I know from building those networks, I know a number of people within different positions and different job propositions have come simply because of that, simply because time was spent on building those networks. So definitely, I suppose the key point of that is I'd recommend that really do branch out and make connections with people within the industry and also within your university degree and others as well. Just on extracurricular activities, so uni can, I think the experience that you have at uni is really what you make it. So it can be simply you rock up for lectures or you podcast them and you just do assignments and more humdrum, but I like to look at it as an opportunity to make something of yourself and also to grow and learn. So with that in mind, throughout my degree, I, like many other students as well, have participated in extracurricular activities, like being a student ambassador. So you go out to schools, you engage with prospective students, also being a student mentor, so mentoring first-year students who are in a position that you were once when you were first year. Also the career mentoring program that Christina has spoken about. That's a great opportunity to engage with people who have actually, they've finished university and they've gone and made something of themselves in the big wide world. So my mentor was from Ernst & Young and she worked in HR there. And that again was an opportunity just to build another network within the professional realm of HR. Also, as Anna was talking about, the student exchange opportunities that are available at UniSA are vast, which is wonderful. I didn't do a whole year or 6 months. Actually, throughout January 2012, I went to Busan in South Korea, which Pukyong National University there, and I spent a month on campus with about 40 other students from different parts of the world and 40 local students from Busan. So we were on campus doing cultural activities, learning languages, learning calligraphy, and it was wonderful to be able to engage with students from other cultures, and there are many networks that, you know, I still have thanks to social networking. Definitely helps in our global world. And probably as well, I would say about the on-campus, the global network that is on campus, there are students from all parts of the world, and I know I've got quite a few people who've graduated for their home countries are China and Singapore, and their networks that I've got, and you know, if I ever go travelling or vice versa, I know that's a strong network and that's always someone to call on. So probably in essence, I would say in terms of the global opportunities that are available, it would be really just to branch out and take take advantage of what is available, and take advantage of, you know, who's in your class. You know, instead of sitting with people that you already know, maybe branch out. You never know where different networks can get you. At the end of the day, university, it's not easy by any means, but you get back what you put into it. So it can be a really rewarding journey, and I have found that, and I hope that many of you also find university rewarding. So thank you for your time, and if you've got any questions, please feel free to ask.
So what were
going to have Anna, Gabriella and myself up here. So if you've got some questions you want to ask, maybe you can shout them out in a loud voice, because if you've got that question, other people might as well. Any burning questions? Well, you do four subjects a week, or four subjects a semester, so that's four times three, about 13 and a half, is it, I think? But that may not be, because you may actually just be working online. So that question is, I mean, it depends. But generally, you will do four subjects per semester to go through your prior. And each subject is normally 3 hours. It might be an hour's lecture or 2 hours lecture usually, or 1 hour one day, another hour another day, and a 1 hour tutorial. So some advice on that. If you are, I would actually think it's much easier to get engaged if you come in for at least some of your classes. I think it must be very lonely out there. Well, I have studied online and it's a different experience. So come in if you can to lectures. I know the lectures are recorded, but come in anyway because you'll feel engaged. Now the really important things are the tutorials. Don't do what I did in my first year, which was not prepare for tutorials. I got a rude shock when they started to direct questions at me and I felt an idiot because I hadn't read. I thought, oh, this is one thing I won't have to do. But if you actually, what I learnt to do was, it was really good that I think that there was method in their madness, was that if you read ahead for tutorials and participate, you will get so much more out of the subject. So my advice is try and have some contact hours on campus. Mix with your other fellows, because this is actually, university is a life-changing experience if you let it be, like Gabrielle said, but you have to get involved. If you just do it remotely online and you're doing your work, it's probably not going to affect you very much. You'll get your degree, but you won't have that rich experience. It was the best time of my life, and I still have friends that I made from uni a long time ago, and more recently when I went back and did my doctorate. So, good question. It depends, but make sure you come and have some contact hours. That would be my suggestion. I'm not sure what the retention rate for first year courses is always. We don't retain as many as most universities don't, because some people come along and try and it's not for them. I would have to say I teach in the postgraduate courses and I teach people who are coming in first time. I rarely have a dropout out of my classes of 40 or 50. And I rarely, so I mean, I might have one dropout a semester. So. Undergraduate, I can't tell you the figures. You could probably, I don't know. You could Google it. It's fairly standard. We're actually working on that. We've got the first year mentors. We're trying to build up support systems for first years, because this is a problem in universities all around the world, not just here in Australia, not just here in Adelaide. So we're working on that, definitely, to increase our retention rates.
That is
it does help a lot, and we do manage to retain more students than
We also have a lot of really good support services here. We have tutoring services. The main problem is students perhaps not getting hooked up with them, not knowing about them, but there are student tutors who will tutor. If you're struggling in a class, they will tutor you for what you can afford. You negotiate the fee with them. They're honours, they're high achieving students. So we have the learning and teaching unit. We have a unit that specialises in international students. I would say that the main thing is if you're struggling, send me an email. Come and talk to me. That's my role, and I will help you connect up with the many, many services that are available on campus.
Can I just add to that one thing as well? I know there's a lot of in the first year there's a lot of courses that you have to do, including accounting, you know, business law, economics, and some people do feel quite daunted by those ones, particularly if you haven't had experience previously with them. There is something set up called PASS. And that's actually where students who, who've previously done it and got high grades, they actually facilitate a study session. So, for instance, I hadn't done accounting prior to my first year at university. I attended past sessions with previous students who had gone very well at accounting, and it really is a big study session. So, just on your point, I did find first year a little bit harder than the other years because it's changing pace. It's trying to get used to the different expectations that university sort of is all about. But if you do reach out to the different areas that are available, like learning teachers unit, PASS, peer mentoring, it does make it a lot easier.
So the main thing is don't suffer in silence. Speak to somebody, speak to your lecturer, speak to your tutor, send an email to me, speak to Lucy Kimber. Go to Learning and Teaching, go to Campus Central, speak out. But I think a lot of the reason why people drop out is they don't get engaged in the first place. So come along, be part of it, join groups, join some of the societies, get to know people, and you will find it's a wonderful experience. So don't feel you're on your own, and don't leave. Come and get some help if you're struggling. But hopefully you won't be. Okay, I think our time might be up. Thank you for your questions, and we look forward to seeing you next year.